بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. My dear brothers and sisters in Islam. Last week in Speaker's Corner, when I was giving the da'wah to this lady, may Allah guide her and open her heart to Islam, she asked me questions about the hadith or a question about the hadith of 72 virgin. Yeah? And I mentioned this hadith is unauthentic. The reason I mentioned that, based upon my research, I came across Ibn Rajab al-Hanbali. He said there is no authentic narrations specify how many women or hur'een, which is a virgin woman in Jannah, the believers will have. Some of them mentioned two, some of them could be more. طيب. Even Ibn Hajar mentioned that, Ibn Qayyim mentioned that. But a brother sent me a hadith, which Imam Albani made sahih. Even Ibn Hajar himself, subhanAllah, made hasan of the hadith. And as our a'imma said, إِذَا صَحَ الْحَدِيثُ فَهُوَ مَذْهَبِي. When the hadith is authentic, that is my madhab. So now I came to know that there is a hadith which is authentic or sound for the martyr, not for anyone. Because Ibn Rajab said, anyone that enters Jannah, you will only have two hur'een, and there is no specific numbers. All the other narrations are weak. So alhamdulillah, I had salaf from the scholars. طيب. But scholars, they are not infallible. We don't blind follow scholars. We follow scholars if they have proofs of them. Now Ibn Albani has a proof of him and other scholars. So now I move on, as our scholar said, إِذَا صَحَ الْحَدِيثُ, wherever the hadith is or is authentic, that's our madhab, I follow. So there is a sound hadith, authentic hadith, says the martyr will have 72 virgin, and not the martyr that kill innocent people. Barakallahu feekum. Not the martyr that kill innocent people claimed as a martyr, the martyr that fight for the sake of Allah to remove oppression, not to bring about oppression as ISIS followers do or Khawarij do. Barakallahu feekum. I hope that is a claim, Allah bless you all. And alhamdulillah, the sister contacted us via our page and I did clarify that to her as well. Barakallahu feekum. And that's from Allah's blessings. We ask Allah to shower us with his blessings in this life and in the hereafter. And may Allah forgive us all. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.